How's it going, you little stinkers? XpeK here again today, bringing you Is It Tuesday Yet? Number 30. We are already on number 30. That is just absolutely insane. I never thought this series would, you know, kind of drag out. I won't say drag out, but, you know, last this long, so to say. Before we get into anything, I want to talk about Nightfall loot. And something that has been on my mind recently, is it just me or is Nightfall loot, I won't say fucking awful, but near there. I mean, I haven't seen one 310 exotic from the Nightfall. I've seen a bunch of like one of my friends, Dylan, he got legendary boots from a Nightfall, and I think the week before, the first week of the Taken King, I got a legendary cloak as a Nightfall reward. Does that have something to do with your light? I don't know, but I have yet to see a 310 exotic drop from the Nightfall, and you figure that would be how to get them, because it's in-game content, but who knows. I thought I would just run that by you guys, see if you guys are having the same little bit of a struggle bus as well. But for this week as well, I wanted to do three Kingsfall reloots, show you guys what I got so far. So far, my characters, I don't really have full raid gear, and when I do hit full raid gear on a character, I will be sure to upload it with you guys, do a couple shaders, and show it off. I'm praying to God that my Titan is the first character to get full raid loot, because the Titan with full raid gear looks amazing. He looks like a rhinoceros. It's awesome. But the raid gear for the Titan's kind of modeled after the War Priest, which you guys will see eventually. Maybe you could probably look up on YouTube, so I'm sure someone has full raid gear for the Titan already. But it looks amazing. I can't wait to get it, and I'll be sure to share it with you guys. Now, this week on my Titan, I was pretty unlucky, I'll be honest. I think I got the chest piece like two or three times. I was like, come on, Bungie, you know, it could have been gauntlets and boots, I could have been really close, I could have possibly got the helmet, but no, I got the chest piece. So we are now like nearing the second week of the Taken King, and it still feels like a really good, solid expansion. You know, like I said before, you know, Dark Below House Wolves, we could call them DLC, and this was an actual expansion. It feels great, the questing system is perfect. You know, I still haven't even completed all the quests, and we're like, what, 2 weeks in? You know, the Crucible quest is long as hell. I mean, it is long. So I still personally believe that Bungie nailed this expansion. I think they did a fantastic job. Of course, there's a couple things that I think they should work on, which I will probably talk about in the video in the near future. But man, they did a great job. So now that we beat the raid on like multiple occasions, we sort of have the mechanics down, and now we're kind of focusing on perfecting each encounter. For example, my group, I think we need to work on our War Priest encounter, because, you know, in normal mode you can revive each other, but in hard mode you can't. And the way we do War Priest is we kind of chain revives off each other. We just sit in the buff that gives you damage on the War Priest, and you die after like 10 seconds, but we keep reviving each other. We just keep passing the buff to each other, and obviously that wouldn't work out in hard mode, because you would die and then you wouldn't be able to be revived. You can't even self-res if you die in the buff, so we definitely gotta work on that. I'm not too sure how that mechanic works. I think you have to kill adds to increase the timer. So obviously over time we'll work on that. But I mean, you know, I made a video earlier this week saying that the Touch of Malice is amazing. And having the Touch of Malice really does make a huge difference. I mean, it's perfect for the raids. So we are nearing the end of the video, and I just want to tell you guys I'm gonna be doing another Q&A type video here soon. And you guys can go ahead and start asking away in the comments section. Now, if you want to do it on Twitter, I will tweet out appropriately. You know, if you want to go ahead and ask me on Twitter, I'll try to screenshot them. But, you know, it kind of scrolls down fast in my interactions. So, for now, just do it through YouTube, and I will tweet out when I'm going to start doing the Twitter ones. So, yeah, if you want to be a part of it, ask anything. I kind of want it to be Taken King related. It can be about cars or anything else. But I kind of want to talk about some topics in the Taken King. Get some opinions out of the way that some people have been asking me. I would like to do it in like a Q&A, kind of be informal and stuff. So yeah, like I said, anything you want to ask, go for it. So before I sign off, I just wanted to let you guys know I'm thinking about revamping the series a little bit. I think I'm going to include some faction packages, because as you all know, you can't really do those anymore. You know, your faction packages don't go to the postmaster. You have to open them at the vendor, and you can only do it one at a time per rank up. So that is a bit unfortunate. We can't do those anymore. You know, it was fun while they lasted. I don't really miss grinding bounties every day, so it is kind of a sigh of relief. So yeah, just let me know what you guys think. I can include some engrams, some faction packages, maybe if I get lucky with like a chest or something. You never know. So just let me know what you guys think. So yeah, that's going to be it for this week, guys. I did get lucky on my Warlock, which you guys will see in just a second. My first time I've saw an exotic drop off Oryx. So anyways, hope you guys enjoyed. I'm signing off. I'll see you guys next week. Take care.